Hey guys, what's going on? It's Garabi Robber here, and I'm going to bring you a short little tutorial today, kind of based off most of your guys' questions on my YouTube pages or videos. First off, I hear everyone asking about brushes all the time. What brush do you use? Like I say in a lot of my videos, I use these basic default brushes all the time. One of the hard one is one of my favorites. I usually take off the spacing though. I have a custom one I made off of the default where I spacing is set at 9%. Usually I just set that to 0, and that's actually like one of my most common. To 1, and then I will do like opacity jitter, pen pressure, and such. But that's like one of my most widely used brush. But I did download a pack from there's an artist that I found on DeviantArt, Darken, and I'll actually show you. These are his brushes for the most part. Some of these, I'd probably deleted a few, but he has really good textures, really cool, unique brushes. And where you can actually go to find these is you go to darken.com with 2 A's, and then you go hover over tutorials, and then you hit my brushes, and you'll download that brush pack, which is really cool that there's an artist out there doing that. And I use one of his brushes all the time. I've seen it in most of my videos. It's kind of a chalky brush. So like in the default ones, you have these chalk brushes, which are really cool, especially when you have some opacity or jitter pen pressure, with pen pressure. But this one right here is one of my more favorite brushes. When you go kind of light, you get like a nice texture. It's good for like rocks and stuff and different landscape and kind of just making generic shapes and textures in the background. But it also can be a really sharp brush. You can press pretty hard, but then you can still get some of these textures, which is cool. And then as you like let off, but what's cool about downloading these packs is you find new techniques within them, but then you can also go and edit it to your liking. You can throw some more scatter on there, different texture, either turn on or off pen pressure, and then just save out a new brush, and it'll go to the bottom, and then you start stacking up your own brushes, and then you can go back in here and be like, I don't want these, just cut some of these out, cut that one out, you can do whatever, and then sooner or later, you kind of have your own custom brush pack of your own that you can start giving out to people if you want. And you can even use these to make brushes. Like I could do this and then save this out as a little brush, add that to my pack. But I just don't want people to get hooked on thinking that brushes are the things. Having a better brush is going to make you a better painter. It's really not. I mean, I'm sure you could have given Van Gogh, the most horrid Walmart brush ever, and you still would have painted something amazing with it. So just don't get stuck on having to have my brushes and where do you get your brushes and all that. Secondly, people have been asking about my swatches. In some of my older videos, I think I was on my MacBook, which might have a different... I think I have it set to a different swatch than on my iMac here. But you can just go into swatches and you should have a bunch of these preloaded ones. Otherwise, sometimes people will post theirs that you can grab. And a lot of times I'm actually adding some of them myself if I find like a good skin tone for a certain mood or setting. I'll slap that in. Different colors that I usually don't think to come across and think to mix, I'll kind of mix them up, and it's cool to play around with them, but I don't get too worried on that, just because all my colors I'm not really picking from the swatches. They sometimes give me ideas on directions to go, but I'm not like, oh, I need a red and I pick that. I'll actually go into the finder or the color picker, sorry, and play around with it so I can see where it is on, not only like for saturation, but the value scale. So I can see if it's on the lighter end or darker end, which is way better than just going up here because these colors are reacting. They're reacting to each other. For instance, I mean, this green right here is going to look really warm compared to the green right below it, and so forth. So I don't really like to do that. I like to pick my colors based off of my palette that's already on my canvas while looking at it here, if that makes sense. So I really don't always have my swatch up there. Sometimes I'll actually have most of it hidden because I find other areas needing more space and such, like the brush or layers and whatnot. I think that's pretty much going to sum up this one. Feel free to ask more questions. I'm always trying to think of ideas for tutorials. So yeah, let me know what your thoughts, input, if I'm an idiot or not. Feel free to talk to me. Thanks.